Daily updates directly to your inbox plus subscribe. Thank you for subscribing. Could not subscribe. Try again later. Invalid email. Michel Prudhomme has emerged as the left field candidate in the race to succeed Pedro Teichen as Rangers manager. Mailsport exclusively revealed this morning that the former Belgium international goalkeeper has applied for the job, and his representatives have already held talks with Ibrox chairman Dave King. Although an outsider among the runners and riders for the job, Derek McInnes remains the firm favorite. Prudhomme is a coach with a decent track record. The 58-year-old won 58 caps for his country, but since hanging up his gloves he has had successful spells in charge at Standard Liège, Gent, FC Twente, Al-Shabaab, and latterly with Club Brugge. Image. AFP. Image. Getty Images Europe. All of which make him a respected coach on the continent. Prudhomme, however, is hardly a household name in Scotland. So just who is he and what would he offer? Rekordsport Online takes a closer look at the Belgian's credentials. Who is he? Michel Prudhomme was one of the best goalkeepers in Europe during the early 1990s when he became the first foreign keeper in Benfica's history. He made his name in his homeland with Standard Liège and KV Mechelen, making over 200 appearances for both and winning the Belgian title twice with Liège and once with Mechelen before moving to Portugal. Image. Getty. Prudhomme won 58 caps for his country and played in the 1990 World Cup in Italy and the 1994 World Cup in USA, where he picked up the Yashin Award for Best Goalkeeper. After retiring in 1999 at the age of 40, Prudhomme was named technical director at Benfica. He then moved into management and his first job was back at Standard Liège, where he had two spells as head coach. Prudhomme has also managed Gent, FC Twente, Al-Shabaab and Club Brugge. What has he achieved as a coach? Image. Getty. Impressively, Prudhomme has won a major trophy with every club he has managed. He had two stints as Standard Liège gaffer, moving into the sporting director role in 2002 before returning as boss in 2006. He then delivered the club's first title in 25 years in 2008. He shocked Belgian football that summer when he moved to Jupiler League rivals Gent. There he finished second in Belgium's top flight but led the club to only its third ever Belgian Cup triumph. In 2010, Prudhomme moved across the border into Holland, where he replaced Steve McLaren at FC Twente. Again, he led his side to a runners-up spot in the Eredivisie and in May 2011 won the Dutch Cup after a thrilling 3-2 victory over Ajax after extra time. After just a year in the Netherlands, Prudhomme was on the move again. This time the destination was Saudi Arabia and Al-Shabaab. In his first year in the desert, he led the club to its first league title in 6 years. His side were undefeated in the league and Prudhomme was named Manager of the Year. Image. Getty. In September 2013, he moved back to Belgium as manager of Club Brugge. He led the club to Belgian Cup success in his second season. But it was in 2016 when he lifted the Jupiler League title, Brugge's first championship victory in 11 years, that he really succeeded. The Belgian Super Cup was also delivered that season with Prudhomme named Manager of the Year. Prudhomme stood down in the summer after finishing second to Anderlecht and after Brugge finished bottom of their Champions League group, losing all 6 games against Leicester, Porto and Copenhagen. He said he needed a rest from football. What's his style? Image. Reuters. Jason Cairnduff. During his playing career it was very much a flowing locks look. But in terms of management style, Prudhomme is known for favoring an expansive 4-3-3 system with traditional wingers. It might sound a little bit Mark Warburton-esque, but Prudhomme has proved he knows how to deliver. a winning side in every country where he has worked. His club Brugge side were taken apart in last season's Champions League though, and he has enjoyed little success on the European front. Is he a serious candidate? Image. Getty Images Europe. An outsider. Prudhomme would be seen as another risk if he were to be appointed by the Ibrox board, and given the disastrous 7-month reign of the Pedro Teich in an experiment, it's expected the decision-makers at Rangers will be looking for a manager who is less of a gamble. That's not his fault, and his credentials stand up as a successful manager. Prudhomme turned down KV Mechelen last week and said he did so because he had no experience of battling at the bottom of a league. He said, "I considered the prospect deeply, and that was purely out of my love for the club. In the end, I decided against it because I have no experience of being in a relegation battle and trying to save a club. I didn't think I would be the right man for the job and regretfully had to decline. But I am very flattered for my former club to consider me." Quote.